Thanks for clicking on WMUR.com. I'm meteorologist Derek Weglars. Obviously, the snow, the biggest concern this evening, the wind starting to get a little gustier too. This is the picture out of Concord that really stood out to us. The weight of the snow certainly has been an issue and starting to really weigh down a lot of the trees. You see them bent over almost on the ground. So this is why our power outage concerns have continued. And I think we're going to see the outage threat continue for at least several hours going forward, well past midnight, as winds continue to gust into tomorrow morning. This is the look at radar the last couple of hours here. Again, snow been the dominant theme, a little bit of rain both at the seacoast initially, and a few patches of rain up in parts of both the Lakes region and far northern Carroll counties where the intensity was just not strong enough to get things over to snow. Now the intensity has picked up. So a couple of bands here on radar to watch. One stretching from Conway south through Laconia and Concord. And the second, the first one still stretches all the way down actually into parts of Milford, Goffstown, and Nashua. The second one's further towards the east through Raymond, Derry, and Salem, even Plastow too. And that one has been stationary for the last couple of hours. So underneath these bands, we will find snow totals that are locally enhanced compared to other parts of the state. And this is the nor'easter really getting going here, now barreling up into the Gulf of Maine, eventually into eastern Maine as we go through the overnight period into first thing tomorrow morning. Visibility is now down well below 2 miles for most spots in the Granite State, especially under these bands of very heavy snow. So the headlines and the main concern continues to be significant wet snow totals. Heaviest snow for most should be between, say, 10 and 11 o'clock before things lighten up and power outages remain the highest concern with the storm. So winter storm warning continues for the entire state. Wind gusts right now are fairly strong in the 30s, and these numbers have been climbing. As we go towards midnight tonight, I'm not shocked if a lot of those numbers aren't to the 40s, if not the lower 50s. So you factor in heavy wet snow and wind, and the power outage potential drastically increases all the way into tomorrow morning. So this is 8 o'clock. We're watching the snow still rolling through. We'll go towards 10. The heaviest snow should be concentrated in and east of Concord, Manchester, and Nashua. In the Monadnock region and the Upper Valley, the snow is starting to lighten up at midnight into early tomorrow morning, and then that's when I think we'll find a lot of these snow bands really fall apart as we go towards daybreak tomorrow before things get a little bit brighter by tomorrow mid-morning. So this is a look at the total snow forecast, so what we got this morning and what we get tonight. Thinking locally higher amounts of 12 or 13 inches where this persistent snow band really lingers across parts of Stratford counties, eastern Hillsborough. This section of the higher terrain really is going to cash in away from the immediate sea coast. Further inland, a bit of a reduction in snow totals in the mountains, again, should do very well with 12 inches or more as we go through the day tomorrow. Impacts: wet snow, obviously high, gusty winds and medium, but again, you factor in the two like I've been mentioning, and power outages will be a concern going forward. Tomorrow's forecast is a complete opposite to what we saw today. A lot of sunshine, especially during the afternoon. In the north, I think we'll find snow showers lingering, temperatures in the upper 20s there, but further south, we should be back into the middle 30s. So some of the snow that's fallen today will continue to melt under full sun tomorrow afternoon.